McMorran, we're back again. We'll continue with the making of the dowel part that we stopped yesterday, or the last video anyway. And we'll now go on to fitting the steel part of the dowel, which basically is a 70mm wood screw. I use these ones basically because I've got a security type drive on them. I keep picking them up and trying to use them for other things and going, oh bloody hell, I've got to find the bloody drive system. So I use it for this. But anyway, 70mm, 6mm diameter roughly. And we'll pilot bore them, pop a bit of glue in and screw them in. Anyway, the bit and countersink is it's a trend one. It's a universal countersink that can be adjusted any length up and down the bit, the drill bit. And first class piece of kit. As I say, I've already got this one in the vise, and we'll just do it. The idea is to pilot. There's already a hole down through the centre made by the core bit, so we're going to extend that down, and it'll give us a countersink in the top of the dowel for to take the head of the screw. So we'll just start it away. We just want it to go into the dowel. That's basically it. Enough to take the head of the screw, and no more. That's it. Just turn around, give it a tap out, and back in the vise with it. And the glue. This time of the year, it's starting to get a bit chilly, so I think we'll give it a little bit of a heat just to warm it up a little bit. Just to get it moving a little, moving easier. Not too much. Plastic bottle, don't want it melting on us. Just gear up a little bit. You know, like ourselves, a little bit of heat does us a world of good, gets us moving. But we're on the turn now. The weather's changing and the autumn's upon us and winter looms large. Anyway, that's enough for that. We'll do. A spray of water. Touch of water on it. Basically just inside it really. Gorilla glue. It's one of the toughest jobs on planet Earth. Expansive glue. So you must be careful just how much you use on it. It just requires a couple of drops of it right into the hole and then flick it off. Down, that's it, ready to go. Right, pop the wood screw down into the dowel, and it's still got about an inch and a quarter to go. This is our old Hilti drill that I use for weight. Gee whiz, that's when the best tools in the world, but there's only certain people who can afford them at one time. There's enough power in the battery just to not to be too excessive in it. If you push it too far, it will split the dowel, and that's no good at all. You don't want that. You don't want to split the dowel at all. And we'll give it a little rub off. Clean. There will be a bit to leach and whatnot on it, and that's the idea, and that gives you a good steel wooden dowel. The wooden dowel in itself would probably hold all right, but the way I make it with the core bit, it gives you a centre hole anyway, I wouldn't do that. It would weaken the dowel situation, so the steel screw through the middle of it, right down into the shank, does the job really, really well. If I, with the antler situation, if I was using this one for the antler, there's times I would actually think about using the threaded rod in it and projecting it up past into the antler. As you can see with this trial piece, this is sometimes what you need to do with the dowel to give you that bit more purchase if there's a length of antler, if it's a longer piece that you're using or not. You've got to pile it back into the antler. The antler itself, in you know, the core of it's porous, it's honeycombed, and sometimes I will soak it in a bit of wood glue, watered down, and let it absorb slightly into it. But I tend to use the araldite situation on that. On the antler situation rather than expansive. I don't want it pushing around. But the Hilti bills are what a weight. Fantastic bit of kit, and what I used to love about going to buy Hilti, I never really bought many tools off them, but I used to buy a lot of the fixings, because obviously when you're working on sites and various jobs, contracts, the architect would specify Hilti fixings, and he had to use them. First class fixings, there is none better. But the sheer indifference when you went into the shop was brilliant. They didn't really care about you. If you didn't know what you were after, you were struggling. If you didn't have it, know exactly what you were going for, you were really, they weren't there to actually help you, or you certainly felt that at times. But their tools and their equipment and everything was first class. I remember as a young lad starting apprentice, and we were doing bin stores, and way back then it was we're taking out the holes for the raw plug, the raw bolts would be the old star drill and the hammer. And it was a big scheme, and we had a lot of bin stores to do, and my boss at the time went away and bought a Hilti hammer drill, and it was like Christmas all over. No more stave thumbs and battered fingers and all the rest of it, and but it made the job go a lot quicker, and it took a lot of the work out of it, and that's the marvellous thing about it, like, you know. Anyway, we'll do another one while I'm here, and you can just follow it through. Just pop it in, little tighten up, drill bit in again. You can see how it works. It's a pretty easy system. Take a bit of practice for the dowels. Make sure you get the dowel situation right. But other than that, once you've got the hang of it, you can't really beat it in terms of a system for putting them together. It works really well. The sticks stick that I use right now has been lying at the back door. It's constantly on the go every day, and it's been lying at the back door for must be 18 months or so, and the joint still is good. There's obviously a bit of fade on things, and I've been meaning to bring it in and bring it up to scratch. I did replace the stud in the bottom there a while back, but it wore out, so I had to put another one in. So that was that. Anyway, I've got water in, touch glue, wood screw, pop it in, and a little drive down into it. That's it. That's lovely. That's fine. And that's basically your dowel situation complete. The matching of the handles to it, or the next part of it, selecting them and putting them together and that. As I said yesterday, I've got loads and loads of stuff. That's the bell. The bell is wrong, and we're coming close. But as you can see, we've now got the dowel completed. You can't do better than that in terms of the dowel situation. First class. And we'll leave it at that for this one. That's basically the dowel situation. The next one, we'll prep the handles and we'll fit them together. But I straightened a bit of briar yesterday. Lovely stuff, briar. You wouldn't think, actually, when you rose hip, you see something with rose hip growing on it, look into the clump and you'll find some old growth that's died off or dying back. And you can cut yourself a stick out of it. It's extremely strong, very fibrous. Difficult to create the dowel on it, actually. It's harder than the hazel in a lot of ways to actually prepare the dowel situation. It requires a bit more work, but it's a lovely texture. And with the right handle on it, this will make a lovely stick. But we'll get to that. But we'll leave it at that for now. And that's the dowel situation complete. Catch you later.